I think it would be fun? I don't know. I thought it would be fun. I thought it'd be fun to create a Wi-Fi React reusable animated React Wi-Fi component. So many buzzwords. Recently, I was working on a project that needed a Wi-Fi icon. Now, this was a React project, and so the idea was that you would be able to pass in the status of the icon, so excellent condition, searching, error, whatever. You'd be able to pass that in as a prop, and the icon would update reactively. This icon had 7 different states, off, searching, error, and then 4 more states for the strength of the signal. Then, just to add another level of fancy, when the icon is in searching mode, it would be animated. Let's open up a terminal within VS Code and create a React app using Create React App. That sounds dumb. Okay, npx create React App Wi-Fi SVG. This will take a minute. Now, let's navigate into the directory that was just created and run our application. So cd wifi svg npm run start. You'll notice that it automatically refreshed our browser, and you should see a spinning React logo indicating that our application is running properly. Now, within app.js, let's modify some of our code. And within our paragraph tag, I'm going to change that text to read one Wi-Fi to rule them all. I'm also going to delete this image tag and our anchor link and give that a save. Notice the browser automatically updated with those changes. Now let's go into app.css and we're going to delete most of this code. Get rid of this, and all of this. Now let's change the background color to a deep purple. Next, let's create a Wi-Fi component where we'll be doing most of our work. So within our source directory, I'm going to create a components folder, and then inside a new file called wifi.js. Within our new file, I'm going to type RAFC and tab. I have a snippet running inside VS Code that will automatically stub out a functional React component. I'll include a link to that within the description below. We'll name our component Wi-Fi. Inside the return statement, let's just add the text Wi-Fi so that we can make sure that it's rendering correctly. Another thing that I like to do is to use named exports with all of my React components. Consistency makes everything easier. You have to remember which components are named exports and which ones are default when they're all named. Consistency leaves less room for error. So we'll say export Wi-Fi. Within app.js, let's go ahead and import our new component. So import Wi-Fi from components / Wi-Fi. And then we can go ahead and include it right here. So if I give this a save, you'll notice our text appears over here on the right inside our browser. Let's jump over to Figma where I mocked everything up. You'll see the Wi-Fi icon that we can use to show all the different levels of connectivity, and for the searching state, this will actually be animated. We can change the opacity on this and add an explanation point on top to show the error state. I'm going to change this back to 100%. And then I also have a Wi-Fi off symbol. The easiest way to get this out of Figma is to stack all the layers on top of each other, group them together, and export them as a single SVG. Now we're going to open the SVG file that was exported in Figma directly into VS Code. Looks a little crazy with all the letters and numbers, don't worry about it. If you don't have experience with SVGs, you can think of an SVG as an Illustrator file for the internet. It's a vector file, which means that it is based on numbers and math. On the other hand, a raster image is based on pixels. You can always make a rasterized image smaller, but you can't make it bigger because you can't add pixels that don't exist. The good news about an SVG is that you can make it as small or as big as you want on your site and control the color within the code. You can also compress and cache it because it's essentially a text file. We're going to copy all of this SVG code and paste it directly within our Wi-Fi component. I'm going to give this a save, and you'll notice as soon as I saved my file, VS Code automatically reformatted my code for me. That's because I have an extension called Prettier that will reformat my code for me. I'll put a link in the description below. You'll notice that our icon is now appearing in the browser. The first thing that we'll want to do is see which part of the image each path is referring to. I'm going to add a display equals none to each path, and then we can turn them back on one by one. Now you can see in the browser that nothing is displaying. Let's comment out the first display equals none. Give that a save, and you'll see that it's our level one. So I'm going to give this a class name of level one. Uncomment that and move on to the next one. You'll see that it's our level two. The third one, this is level three. Move on to the next one, level four. Move on to the next one. This is our off. And let's move on to the next one, and this is our error state. It is the only one left. Now we can go ahead and remove all of our display nones. Give that a save, and you'll see everything layered on top of each other. Let's put a class name on our SVG so that we can target the elements within our CSS without worrying about it conflicting with other pieces on our site. Let's open up our app.css, and here's the fun part. This is where we get to style all the pieces. By default, let's hide all of our paths, and then we can turn them back on based on the state. I'm going to move some windows around so that we can see our code and our component at the same time. So for a poor connection, let's add a class of poor connection here to the top. Target this within our CSS by saying Wi-Fi icon, poor connection. And since these items are on the same tag, you'll notice there's not a space in between the two. And then we'll say level one, display block. Give that a save, and you'll see our item appear within our browser. We can do the same thing for each of the remaining levels. So we also have a fair connection. So let's change poor to fair. You can actually just duplicate this code. Change this to fair, and in this case, we want to target level one and level two. Give that a save, and you'll see our icon update. Okay, so for level three, let's call this a good connection. And we can duplicate this, add a level three. For excellent connection, same process. And we'll add a level four. Perfect. For the Wi-Fi off section, something similar. For the air connection, we'll go through the same method, except we also want to change the opacity for each of the levels. So let's grab this code, change excellent condition here to error. And we'll want to change the opacity to 20%. And then we also want to target our error icon. that a save. Awesome. This is a last state search, and it's very similar to our excellent connection in that all the bars are displaying, except they will also need to be animated. So I'm going to change this class to say searching, or search is fine. Give that a save. Within CSS, you can create an animation by using the @ keyframe. So we're going to designate what each of our keyframes need to be animated to. So I'm going to say searching. That's what our animation is going to be called. And I'm going to say at 0%, we want our opacity to be 0.2, so 20%. At 25%, so 25% of the way through our animation, we want the opacity to be at 100%. Then at 50%, we want it to be back to our 20%, and it'll be 20% in the end as well. This makes it easy because there's four bars, and so there's also four keyframes. Let's come on down, and I'm gonna specify the animation for level one. So Wi-Fi icon search, level one. Here, I'm gonna say animation searching, and this is using this label that we named our keyframes up here, searching. It's gonna have a duration of 2 seconds. We're going to use ease. You can see here there's different ways that you can animate. We're gonna say ease, and we're gonna say it needs to animate infinitely. I'm gonna duplicate this code, and this is fine for level one, but as you get onto level 2, 3, and 4, they will need to be offset. So I'm going to add for level 2 a animation delay of 0.5 seconds. For level 3, I'm going to give it a delay of 1 second. And for level 4, I'm gonna give it a delay of 1.5 seconds. Obviously, you can speed up or slow down your animation depending on the delay and the duration. The only remaining piece that we have is to make this class dynamic so that it can be passed in through a prop. So here on line 6, where I have the class, I'm going to update this to say, if there is a status provided, display Wi-Fi icon plus the status, or if it's not defined, just display Wi-Fi icon. And here on line 3, we'll pass this in as a prop. Give that a save. Now within app.js, we can add status is a poor connection. Give that a save. You'll see one dot. Change this to search. Give that a save. Change this to error. Give that a save. Awesome. Technically, we're done, but let's take this another level. This looks great on a dark background, but what if we want to make our component more reusable and put it on a white background? You know, dark and light themes are all the rage right now. The way that we can do this is actually very simple because we're using an SVG and can change the colors in our code. Let's jump back to our app.css and create some CSS variables. Now, the cool thing about CSS variables is that they're scoped. So we can define a default and then change everything by changing the parent class. CSS variables are pretty easy to set up. You can specify it with a double dash, whatever name you want to call it. And in this case, we're going to use our hex code. Then within your code, you can say color, and you'll use the var as a function to pass in whatever variable you want to reference. So in our case, you remove that. I'm going to go ahead and change this to be excellent connection. And down here, I'm going to create a Wi-Fi icon class where I'm going to define our colors. So I'm going to say icon color. I'm gonna pass it that yellow that we've been using. Then I'm also gonna create one called error color and give that a save. You'll notice that even though the icon color is yellow, I'm not calling the variable yellow. That's because I want the name to be more semantic. If I ever change that color, calling the variable yellow doesn't make a whole lot of sense. That we want the variable names to tell us what they represent, not what they are. Now we can set the default within our path definition here. So I'm going to say fill, because when you're talking about SVGs, you use fill instead of color. So fill var icon color. Give that a save. Everything should look the same. Then if I come down to our error definition, we will use our error color variable. If you're curious to see how these are working, let's just change this color for a second. Perfect. Pretty cool. Okay, so now within our app.js, I'm going to add a class to our header tag, and I'm going to call it inverse. Now within our CSS, I'm going to say app header inverse, background color is white. Give that a save. And our color is gray. So now you can read the text. Now I'm going to also override our colors. So I'm going to say inverse Wi-Fi icon. Let's copy these and move them down. I'm going to change these colors here. If I change our connection here to say error, so you can see our explanation point, you'll see everything works. So we can simply change the color of our icon and the background by only removing that inverse class. The cool part is we now have complete control over the icon and the colors being used.
Woo-hoo,
woo-hoo, woo-hoo. Oh, brother. Okay, that's it, awesome. Yeah, I'll post the code on GitHub. You can download it, modify it, use it, whatever you want. Link is in the description below. If you like this video and want to see more on design and development, please hit the subscribe button below. Hit the bell icon if you want to receive notifications when new videos are posted. Until then, keep coding.